While the internet has so many wonderful things to offer, video, social media, inspiration, art, instructions on how to do just about anything, there are some dark corners of this vast place that we rarely hear about if you're not looking for it. This is the tragic case of Valentina Grigoryeva and how her gruesome death ended up being witnessed by thousands of people in real time as a popular Russian streamer documented the entire incident. Hey humans, it's Hannah. Welcome back to my channel. Or if you're new here, I do videos on creepy and disturbing things. I have some really quick notes for this video before we get started. I know that you probably saw the trigger warning in the beginning, but I just want to reiterate that this video is going to involve discussions of domestic abuse, violence, and some disturbing clips, though they will not be graphic. Second, I am not Russian, and this story happened in Russia. So if I say some of the names wrong, I'm trying my best, but I'm really sorry if I mispronounce anybody's names. Sorry, Russian friends. And last, I just want to let all of you know that I could not find one truly unbiased, non-tabloid source on this topic. I went through every article I could find on this topic, and I could not find any source on this story that wasn't at least a little tabloidy. So all the information that I found was consistent with each other for the most part, and I will say if it wasn't, but I just feel like it needs to be put out there that take everything with a grain of salt, like all news stories, but especially this one, because I couldn't find any non-biased real news sources for it. In Ivanovka village, a town near Moscow in Russia, 30-year-old Stas Reshetnikov, known online as Staff Reeflay or just Reeflay, was live streaming, as he often did in early December of just last year. Sometime during the live stream, Reeflay kicked his girlfriend outside onto the balcony in sub-zero temperatures. She was likely pregnant at the time. Not only that, but she was barely wearing any clothes. She was also in her underwear. As she yelled and begged for her boyfriend to let her back into the house, into the warmth, he ignored her, continuing his live stream and thousands of people watching the whole thing happen. Even after realizing that his girlfriend was quote unquote half dead outside, which I assume means that she was becoming lethargic and less responsive, he continued to do nothing and continued the stream. Finally, Reeflay goes to get her from outside and let her back in, but he finds what he believes is her unconscious body instead, and he starts to try to revive her. He can be seen dragging her body into the hallway. Here's a partial clip without her full body.
Бля, ребят, мне кажется, она мертвая, нахуй. Я вам отвечаю. Валя, Валя, Валя. Валя. Валя, ты живая? Бля, это надо скорую помощь вызывать. Мне кажется, она мертвая, ребят.
Reeflay starts to plea for her, and he starts to say things like, quote, Valya, are you alive? My bunny, what's up with you? Valya, Valya, damn, you look like you are dead. And, bunny, come on, tell me something. I'm worrying. Damn, I don't feel her heartbeat. In the full video, which has been thankfully deleted from the internet, you can see that he drags his dead girlfriend's body into view of the camera and he starts feeble attempts at CPR. He even tells her, I love you, as he begs her to wake up. But Reeflay then finally realizes that she's not just unconscious, but that she's dead. Reports say that at this point, at least one of the viewers called the authorities, and Reeflay can also be seen making a phone call in the video to somebody, which I assume is also authority or some sort of emergency services. He then picks up his girlfriend's lifeless body and moves it over to the sofa. He also covers her body in blankets as if that would do any good at this point. Then he sits back down in his gaming chair and continues to stream, telling his audience, guys, no pulse, she's pale, she is not breathing. One of the viewers on the stream even asks Reeflay if this is some sort of stunt or hoax, and Reeflay confirms that no, it's real, she's really dead. He continues the stream for 2 hours after her death, even after the paramedics come and pronounce her dead. Reeflay then was thankfully arrested on the scene. Now, I know this is going to be shocking to a lot of you, but this is not the first time that Reeflay has put his hands on Valentina. Previous streams and clips of Reeflay have shown clear abuse of not only his girlfriend, but other people, and just shady behavior in general, and just that they had a very toxic relationship. In one video, Reeflay can be seen spraying his girlfriend in the face face with pepper spray on the couch while she screams in pain. In other videos, there's proof of him straight up hitting her and just verbally abusing her. In another video, we see Valentina actually pull a knife during one of their heated arguments. Which, for me, I personally think that that was probably self-defense at that point because she knew what he was capable of and knew what he often resorted to. There's other proof that he had smashed plates over her head. There is other clips of Reeflay with not his girlfriend, but with other people encouraging or doing these other types of abuse. I saw a lot of them. I might put some less graphic ones in here or parts of the clips in here, but just know, I mean, you can find them if you really want to, but they're pretty disturbing and it just shows a pattern of behavior that this guy is very sick and he's just kind of a pile of crap in general. So we don't know exactly how long Valentina was outside for. The neighbors say that it was about 15 to 20 minutes, but other reports say that it could have been hours. The initial report said that investigators suspected Valentina died of course of hypothermia, being left out in her underwear in sub-zero temperatures. People were outraged at this point because if this were the case, Reeflay would only face up to 2 years in prison at best if it was found that she died of hypothermia. However, later, kind of thankfully, even though it's very tragic in itself and terrible in itself, it was found that she did not actually die from hypothermia. When examining the body, they found bruising on Valentina's face, and Reeflay finally admitted to have hitting her, especially in the face, that day of her death. Her official cause of death was craniocerebral trauma, and including some hemorrhaging of soft tissues. So this, meaning that Reeflay meant to do harm on her, changes it to at least manslaughter, so he is now facing up to 15 years in prison. 15 years to me, even if he gets the max sentence of 15 years, still seems like nothing compared to what this piece of human garbage has done and inflicted on people, but I guess I'll take 15 years over a measly 2. Also realize it's a different country with different rules and different laws. Reeflay, of course, maintains his innocence and claims that she died of a stroke outside in the cold, even though they determined that was not the cause of death. There's also this big debate on Reddit about Reeflay's reaction to the whole thing right after she died. Here's that clip of what he did after she was laying on the couch and he went back to streaming.
Я не впустил её в комнату, потому что она обосралась в коридоре, блядь. Почему? Зачем я не впустил? Я вам клянусь. Если человек жив, если он оживет, я буду только с ним до конца своей жизни. Да, вот.
Стас, тебе весь чат пишет, скорая, открой ворота.
А, да там открыто все, алло.
In my personal opinion, it looks 100% like he's fake crying after her death. Some people's opinions were that this could have just been shock, everybody reacts differently to these stressful situations, etc., etc. I get that, and in a lot of cases that's true, but in this particular case, I think it was bad acting. Because he's not just crying, he can be seen weeping, and then he's drinking, and then looking back at the stream all casually and talking to the audience. No, he did not intentionally take Valentina's life that day. But anyone who abuses their partner, or anybody for that matter, is physically capable of killing them. If you're just gonna beat your partner and use violence against them and to control them, you can't pretend like it was an accident when one day you kill them. I really don't care what anybody says about this particular part of the story. This guy was abusing her clearly for their entire relationship, and you don't get to just say, "Welp, I didn't mean to," when you end up taking another life. That's just not the way it works. I just think for all the violence and just crazy behavior that he was used to, and all the other behavior I've seen in the clips of him, this wasn't shocking to him. I think he'd seen much worse, and this was not shocking. I think he was weeping because he knew that he was in real trouble now, and he knew that he was gonna get caught. And if that doesn't convince you, then remember that after all of this, even though he was acting all sad on camera, later he basically took back that remorse. He later said, and I quote, What is there to regret? I didn't really do anything. So yes, I do think in a lot of situations, shock can make people act extremely weird, and we can't judge people on the way they grieve or the way they act after something so distressing happens. But in this particular case, I think this guy was just a real pile of crap. And even if he didn't intend to kill her, he abused her for so long that he could not have known that that was not a possibility. Finally, motive. Why did he do this? There are actually three possible motives that we know of. First, there's a rumor that somebody watching his live stream offered him the equivalent of $1,000 to kick Valentina out and put her out in the cold. The concept of doing abusive and violent things live on the internet in exchange for monetary gain is not a new concept, and it definitely wasn't a new concept for Reeflay. It's called trash streaming. Just some examples include anything from beating someone, burying people alive, breaking eggs on their head, all the way to sexual assault, pretty much anything you can think of. It kind of reminds me of Red Rooms, except it's not on the dark web. According to several sources, as well as several people on the same Reddit thread, this is actually becoming quite a popular thing on the internet, especially in undeveloped countries such as Russia. Someone on this Reddit thread who claims to be from Russia said that their police force aren't really there to protect the people, but really there to protect the government from its people. So it's just a very different system and culture than Western cultures. And so what's really even sadder about this situation is that if it didn't involve Valentina's death, the cops there basically don't really give a shit. Apparently, simply calling the cops in these types of situations doesn't work the same way as it does in Western cultures like the US, Canada, and Europe. Authorities, basically from the people that were talking on Reddit, authorities don't come running. Some even said that domestic abuse really is not as big of a deal there, and it's more accepted, and so the cops just don't really care that much about those types of calls. Now, I can't stress this enough. Obviously, that is a generalization, and that is just something cultural that I've heard from some people that say they're from there. That does not by any means mean that all Russian people are like this whatsoever. Just like any country, most of them are still very good people, and they are just as appalled by this type of thing going on as we are. And we have to remember that we know that stuff like this is happening under our noses in the US and other industrial countries. The outcomes and the punishments are just very different. But I thought it was interesting that there's an entire name for this community of people online called trash streaming. So the second possible motive was that Reeflay was just mad at her. They just got in another one of their fights and he kicked her out because they were in a fight. The last possible motive was that he kicked her out so that, quote unquote, she did not stink. Valentina had apparently suffered from a bowel disease, and Reeflay kicked her out as a punishment. I have a feeling that it was a combination of all three of the above motives. And based on his past, being paid to do something like this seems quite possible, so I think whether it involves the other two motives or not, I do definitely believe that somebody paid him money to kick her out. So I've been trying to figure out any updates on this story because it happened 4 months ago and I can't find anything recent on it. And I found a couple articles from April of this year, but they're all in Russian, of course. So from the translating that I could do using Google, it just said that he is in fact going to court under the pretense that he hurt her on purpose and that he caused her bodily harm on purpose and that this could have been intentional, or at least it should be counted as manslaughter. I don't think he's been sentenced yet. I believe he's still going through the court proceedings. Please let me know what you think down in the comments below of this story. Let me know if you have any other insight. Leave this video a like if you enjoyed it, and I will see everybody in the next one.